Morning, boys. This is Mr. Giomini. Today we talked about surface area, so I'm going to make a little video beforehand. I'm going to show this to you in class today to kind of help you out. But also, this is going to kind of deviate a little bit from the way the book is showing you. Sometimes, you know, book is good for some people and other people need a different way. I kind of like the way I'm about to present. I'm not saying it's the best way, but kind of give you a little bit of hand, see if we can't figure something out another way for you. Okay, so if I'm looking at this problem here, surface area of a triangular prism. I know it's a triangular prism because both bases are triangles, so it's a triangular prism. Now, I've already labeled some of the dimensions of the shape. We have the height of this triangle is 5. We have the base is 3. We have the length of this rectangle here, the bottom part here, is 6. We have the diagonal here, which is 4. Okay, now what I'm going to do, surface area, I need to find the area of all the faces on this shape, on this three-dimensional shape. Now if I take a look, I see I have two triangles. It's kind of tough to tell, but I have a rectangle here and a congruent rectangle here. And then I have the bottom part, which is another rectangle. Now all the rectangles aren't necessarily all congruent. So I'm going to label the triangles 1. Because those are both the same. Okay, I'm going to label the bottom here shape 2. And then I have these two rectangles here that kind of form the sides. I'm going to label them 3. So I essentially have 3 shapes put together to form this triangular prism. Now I must find the area of all 3 of the different faces and then combine them. So let's do the area of the triangle first. So I know that the formula for area of a triangle is area equals base times height divided by 2. Or you can also use 1/2 base times height, whatever you like to use. Now, I'm going to change colors here. So I can tell you right now that the base of this triangle is 3. So I'm going to plug 3 into my formula. 3 times the height of this triangle is 15, or 5, I'm sorry. I started multiplying. I know I need to divide that by 2. Okay, so if I multiply out, 5 times 3 is 15. 15 divided by 2 gives me 7.5, and that'd be square feet. But recall, I actually have two triangles. So this is the area of this triangle here. Because these triangles are congruent, it's also the area of this triangle here. So because I found the area of one triangle, I must now multiply this by 2. I'm going to double it because I need to find the area of both triangles. So since they are congruent, I just go 7.5 times 2. So I know that the area of the two triangular faces together are 15 square feet. Okay, so I am done with my triangles. I may shade them in so that I don't have to use them again. Okay, let's look at the area of another one of these. Let's go to shape 2, which is this rectangle here. Now, if I trace this rectangle, let me grab this here. Okay, so this rectangle essentially goes from here to here, then it extends across, comes back down, and across. Now if I take a look at it, now I have to identify the dimensions of that rectangle. Well, I could see it has a length of 6 and a width of 3. Okay, so area of a rectangle. Let's go back to that formula. So I'm going to hold on to this number because when I'm doing surface area, I'm going to combine all these. So I'm going to circle this number because I need to come back to it. That's the two faces, the triangular faces, the bases. So now I need to find the area of that rectangle. Now area of a rectangle is length times width. Okay, so we said that the length was 6 times the width, which was 3. 6 times 3 is 18 square feet. I should probably keep consistent and label all of these the same. I jump them back and forth. So it's 18 square feet. Okay, now I'm going to circle that because that is another measurement I'm going to have to combine at the end. Finally, I have my last two triangles. I'm sorry, my last two rectangles. So let me trace over those so we can get a visual of where they're at. So I have this rectangle here, which now extends like this. And I have that same rectangle which forms, this is the, if you want to look at this right side, and I have that same rectangle that forms this left side. All right. Now, let me take a look for dimensions, because it's not going to be the same dimensions as the other shape, as the other rectangle was. The other rectangle, if we recall, the one that kind of forms that we're sitting on, is 6 by 3. This is also 6, but if I look at the diagonal, it's 6 by 4. Okay, and there are two of these. So whatever answer I get, I'm going to double. So same formula for rectangle, area equals length times width. The length is 6 times the width, which is 4. 6 times 4 is 24. But recall, that's just this face. I must also consider this face over here and add it. So I can multiply 24 by 2. 24 times 2 gives me 48. Okay, now, and it's 48 square feet. I'm almost done. I now must combine all three of those face, or all 5 of those faces. This is 2 of the faces. This is 1 of the face, and this is 2 of the faces. So, surface area is going to equal to 15 plus 18 plus 48. Okay, let's see if I can do this in my head. 15 and 18 gives me 33. Okay, so that's 33 plus 48. 8, 9, 10, 11. Carry the 1, group the 1. 4 plus 3 is 7 plus 1 is 8. That is 81 square feet for the total surface area. So that is my final answer. All right, hope this helps you.